place to stop and the best place to shop is Kohl's Black Friday. Stores open Thursday at 6 p.m. with incredible Black Friday doorbusters. Get the PlayStation 4 or a 49-inch 4K HD TV for just $249.99. The Fitbit Alta is $99.99. And get $19.99 toys. Plus, only once a year, everyone gets $15 Kohl's cash for every $50 spent. Kohl's. Select styles. Hours may vary by location. Doorbusters valid while supplies last or until 1 p.m. Friday. See store or Kohl's.com for details.
You're listening to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
International success coach and noted author Constance Arnold delivers life-changing strategies through her own spiritual practices, as well as with best-selling authors and experts that she interviews. Think, Believe, and Manifest is specially designed to empower your mind and words to work for you and to bring about a life you've been dreaming of. And now, here's Constance Arnold.
Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network. And, of course, you know who I am. I am Constance Arnold, host of the Think, Believe, and Manifest talk show. Guess what? I'm so grateful that you've joined me from all over the globe today. And I can truly say that I know that your life will never be the same again. Well, how are you doing? I pray that you are making a decision, because it is a decision, right, to create and have a wonderful day. It's a beautiful fall day here in Atlanta. The trees are just beginning to turn. I just love this season of the year. I have a walking trail in the new subdivision that I live in, and I walked this week, and I was just so grateful to God because it was so beautiful. So it's beautiful here, and I hope that wherever you are, that you are creating a beautiful day. Well, today I have a sort of new kind of show. The Spirit just downloaded to me and said, why don't you have some of your listeners come on and share their own personal law of attraction success manifestations stories. And that's what we have today. We have three beautiful people from different places all over the globe, different genders, different races. And so we're going to get right to it. Just really quickly, of course, you know, you can visit my website at fulfillingyourpurpose.com. Check out my coaching. I'm currently helping a lot of people with a weight release, a thin from within. It's transformational coaching, no quick gimmicks. Once you transform your thinking, you can literally begin to cut your food in half. Just met with one of my clients who released, I didn't recognize her, 90 pounds. She looks gorgeous. So email me at constance@fulfillingyourpurpose.com. And while you're on that website, of course, I know this show is nurturing, shifting, and changing your life. And I want to give you the opportunity to donate. So here we go. My very special guest, my very special first guest is Kelvin, and he's going to come on and share his story, his Law of Attraction success story, and I'm going to let him talk. So, Kelvin, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
Hey, Constance, thanks for having me, and thank you for this privilege to share my story with the world.
Well, good. Just really quickly, I know that you're in the military, and want to thank you for that up front. And you recently got a promotion. Tell our listeners what a branch of the service you serve and what's your promotion.
Okay, so I am a soldier in the Army. I recently got received a promotion, well, earned a promotion, I guess I should say.
Yeah.
To captain.
Congratulations.
So, thank you. Thank you so much. So right now I'm still a first lieutenant, but soon I'll be pinned captain. I'll be Captain Riddle. So I'm looking forward to that.
Well, tell us your Law of Attraction story.
Okay. So really quick before I start, I just want to share a little pearl of wisdom.
Okay.
And I just want to ask a question to your audience. You know, it's amazing that, isn't it amazing that we can know a thing and have conceptual knowledge of spiritual principles, yet we forget to apply it when life goes haywire? That's something that sticks with me, because oftentimes I find myself in situations and I have all these tools and things that I have inside of me, and sometimes I just forget to apply them. They just don't surface. And so having people like you and my support system, it allows me to allow those things to surface. So I want to thank you for that, for what you do, Constance, and and being there in those tough times and in the podcast. I mean, your archive is so rich. So thank you for that.
Thank you. Thank you. And I know that when you were in Iraq, right, serving, you've sent me an email and said, Constance, you need to give a shout out to the military. And thanks for that reminder.
Yeah, absolutely. That was something that you were shouting out to everybody across the globe. And I was like, well, what about me? What about folks over here in Iraq? So, yeah, I had to remind you about that.
Mm-hmm. So tell us your story.
Okay, so as you mentioned, I was in Iraq. So a few weeks after returning from Iraq, I began to feel, you know, really low. And the weird thing about that was I didn't quite know why. And because I didn't know why I was feeling low, I didn't really know how to overcome it. So I just knew, you know, that, you know, my soul was weak. And if my soul was weak, I couldn't prosper. So I didn't have the how-to. I didn't know where to look. I didn't know the outcome. So after seeking outwardly and to no avail, I started seeking inwardly for the things that God has already put in me. Mm-hmm. So I ran across the show, The Power of the Imagination, about 8 months ago with Mr. James B. Powers.
Wow.
And something he said really struck me. And he said, in order to create a new experience or alter your life, you have to change your thoughts. And that thoughts are things. So with that, you know, that really, you know, and the law of attraction says that what you think you create, what you feel you attract, and what you imagine you become. And so with that, I realized that there's connection between having our souls aligned to the creator and the ability to prosper here in the earth. And I knew that feeling, that emotion, where I was spiritually, it wasn't where I was supposed to be. So I started replacing my thoughts with God thoughts. And I started speaking kingdom principles. And I began to grab those thoughts and align with depression and things that were just depressing me. And I really just started to grab scriptures and start to speak and affirm things that contradicted those thoughts. So one morning after devotion, I started listening to the Power of Imagination. It really helped pull me out of that. And the second principle I used was...
Let me say something really quickly. I'm going to make sure I tell James Powers. But what you did was you deliberately decided that you were going to change what you think. And I know that your thinking can really pull you out of depression because you can, your thinking and your feeling, because when you begin to quote the scriptures and the other truth, it replaced that old way of thinking with the new. And you probably were suffering from some form of, you know, sadness or depression. And I'm not trying to clinically analyze you, but I mean, you were in a war and you probably saw and experienced many things, and men are supposed to be strong and just have it all together. You were away from your family. And so it's a big deal what you did, Kelvin. And I just want people to hear that, because you made a decision that you were going to replace truth. And truth always reigns. So I just commend you for doing that.
Well, thank you. And I would just say that, again, this is something that I was dealing with personally. I really didn't know if I was depressed for sure. Mm-hmm. I didn't really seek any help or any professional help, although the Army has, you know, a plethora of tools and resources that soldiers can use for situations like that. I really wasn't sure. I just knew that what I was feeling wasn't me, and I knew that I could overcome it. Without a doubt, I knew that. So I started seeking ways to do that.
So did you do it every day? Did you have a set aside time when you did it? What did that look like?
Absolutely, every day. So my routine is that I have my what we call the hour of power. So I get up about an hour early before I have to go to work. And because I'm so busy during the week, I have to program myself before I go out and deal with the world. Mm-hmm. I have to program my thoughts. I have to program how I'm going to feel and all that stuff, because I know that, you know, things are going to come up against me. So in the morning, every day, whether I'm on or off the clock, I get up and I get up early because I have two small kids as well. So mm-hmm. I have to get that quiet time to program me before I go deal with the world.
Wow. That's powerful. And what's the second way that you've used the law of attraction?
The second way was gratitude. Gratitude was the second tool. So law of attraction says giving thanks for what I do have instead of what I don't have, and focusing on what I do have instead of what I don't have will amplify what I do have. And that came from, you know, there are scriptures that talks about giving thanks, you know, in the good times and the bad times. But then there was a show I listened to back in your archive called Gratitude. And you said, whatever you focus on, you get more in your life. And that simple line just helped me to shift my focus. Hmm. And so Bob Proctor says, gratitude is the great mental adjuster and the atonement. So thanksgiving and praise to the creator of the universe was part of my strategy. And that's simple, but it's powerful. So giving thanks in the midst of the storm was what helped me to come out of it. And when I began to give thanks, I realized what it was that was depressing me. It was my ambition. My ambition was on the shelf. You know, a lot of times when we go down range, we call it in the military. So we go overseas, our lives, everything, we feel like everything, I know I did personally, I feel like everything was put on halt.
Yeah.
9 months, you know, my ambition, my goals, my business ventures, my investments, all the things that I wanted to do outside of the military that I you know, endeavor in, those things were on hold, and I didn't know where to pick up, and that's what I was missing. I wasn't missing being a husband. I wasn't missing being a father. I wasn't missing, because when I came back, all that stuff came to me naturally, and I fell right into it, and I could find that I was happy, but my what I'm created to be. I'm very business savvy. I'm smart when it comes to business. So, but that stuff was on hold and I couldn't figure it out. So giving thanks helped me to overcome that. And when I aligned my thinking with the Word of God, I found joy, and that joy gave me strength. And when my soul, you know, was lifted, I started to see things just fall into line. So long story short, in a few short weeks, I'll be down in Orlando attending a business conference. And I'll be, you know, amongst giants in the real estate investing world for 3 short days. And I'm so excited about that, because I get to network and I'm putting myself back out there. Mm-hmm. I'm not allowing myself to sit here and feel low. I'm putting myself back out there and I'm getting in the game conference. And I really want to appreciate you and what you do and who you are, because that has really helped me to get myself back on track.
Wow. You know, just 2 major principles, you know, gratitude and just changing your thinking. And I just want to say to listeners, you know, you see that he just decided to listen to the show, but also to implement what he heard. And that was a priority to him. And gratitude and thanksgiving and praise will pull you out of anything. Ask me how I know. And it opens your eyes. And so that's what happened to you, Kelvin. You decided to be grateful. And then God just gave you the insight, the strength, the renewed vision to say, okay, let's make some things happen. Is that what happened?
That's what happened. And once I started reaching out and talking to people, my phone was ringing, my email was overflowing. And, you know, I got the invite. And I found the right tools to help me move forward in my business practices outside of the military. So,
well, you know, I say usually every other Sunday, I say one word from God or one truth or one revelation or one insight can really help you. So would you say that that's nothing but the truth, Kelvin?
That is nothing but the truth, undoubtedly.
And so the 2 things that you did just sort of pulled you out. And I just want to stay on this just for a minute, simply because it seems so small. And the fact that you even practice your hour of power, I'm sure you're very busy. And some mornings when you wake up, you probably don't feel up to it. So are you committed to the hour of power? Tell me a little bit about that.
I am committed to my hour of power. If you come to my house, we have signs and things and scriptures that I've written out, affirmations that I've written out, because, you know, my thoughts are literally on the wall. So if something contradicts who I am and who I know myself to be, I see it on my wall. I can see that thought and I can read it and I can affirm it. And that hour of power is just so important. I mean, it's like software on your computer. If you don't have that antiviral software on your computer, if you haven't programmed it on your computer, when the viruses and adware, malware, when all that stuff starts to come, you won't be equipped, and now you're vulnerable. But when you program yourself and you have a defense against that, because the world, you know, inherently there's a lot of trash and stuff out there you're gonna have to deal with. But I have to take that time to program myself every day. It's unquestionable. Yeah. There's no way around it for me.
And so, Leslie, did the Law of Attraction Radio Network, did it help you, or did this show help you when you were abroad in Iraq? Is it Iraq or Iran?
I was in Iraq, and absolutely, okay. this show helped me because, you know, there's not a lot of downtime when you're overseas and you're on mission. There's not really a lot of downtime, but I made a point, you know, during my shower time, because that was really the only personal time I got was my shower time and getting in bed. Really. So, and laundry, that was it. That was it. There was no personal time. So I made it a point to listen to this show whenever I was doing laundry or taking a shower, or because I had, you know, they have the new, you know, waterproof Bluetooth headphones. So now you can take a shower with your headphones on. But, you know, I use that kind of stuff to help program me, even to deal with situations and circumstances there in Iraq. And a lot of the depression and oppression and things you can see when you're over there, it just helped me to stay focused on who I was and what, you know, not to get bogged down in what I was doing. You know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean. You know, you're just exhibit A of someone who's living life, who has issues and problems and responsibilities and deadlines, but you have really prioritized what's important in your life. And I think that the two examples that you shared, that people can begin to say, aha, I'm going to go back and listen to some of Constance's show, and not just listen, but really begin to implement it like you did in your life, and just see the miraculous happen.
That's absolutely right. I urge everybody to go back and find, and it's probably about 2 years ago now, because that's when I first started listening to you. Mm-hmm. Find a show on gratitude and listen to how powerful that show is. And the show, the power won't be activated in your life until you apply it. So listening is not enough. You have to put it into action. So I just urge everybody to go and do that.
Well, thank you so much for coming on and just being honest. It's great to hear a male's perspective, you know, about life and responsibility and priorities, and the fact that you might have even been dealing with a little depression, and that you were honest and vulnerable about that. And, you know, Kevin, I wish you nothing but the best. I just see and feel great things for you and your family. And once again, we just appreciate all your service, and you are a remarkable spiritual man.
Thank you again, Constance, and it's an honor to serve. And thank you for this opportunity, and I hope to do it again soon.
Okay, everybody, we're going to go to these quick commercials, but then I just want everyone to repeat after me my new mantra, which is what God gave me. I don't know if you've heard it or not, Kelvin, but it says, today is the best day of my life. And 2016 is the best year of my life. So I want you to stay tuned, because I have two more personal Law of Attraction success manifestation stories just for you. So stay tuned.
Do you have an upcoming event where you need a dynamic speaker? Constance Arnold is a sought-after keynote speaker that will enlighten the entire audience with proven strategies that are aligned with your organization's vision and mission. An experienced speaker for major Fortune 500 companies, Constance has entertained audiences with inspiring change. Constance would love to make your next event an extraordinary success. Contact her today at constance@fulfillingyourpurpose.com.
For the past 30 years, Constance Arnold has coached clients globally in the areas of relationships, wealth, and career. Her vast clinical background gives her extraordinary understanding of human behavior to accelerate manifestation. Every coaching client receives proven action plans to create change from the inside out. Constance will be right by your side. Talk to her today at Constance@fulfillingyourpurpose.com.
Well, earlier this month, I asked for anyone who had a wonderful Law of Attraction story to write in. You know why? Because I want to hear from ordinary people doing what I call extraordinary manifestations using the Law of Attraction, because the law or the principle is that the Law of Attraction will work for anyone who will work it. And I received a wonderful email from Janet, and I wanted her to come on and share her story with all of you. So, Janet, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
Thank you, Constance. It's so nice to be on your show.
Well, how long have you been listening to my show?
I've been a listener of the Law of Attraction Radio Network and your show for at least 3 or 4 years now.
Wow. Well, you know, when I received your email, I was just so excited about it. And so tell our listeners just about a couple of your manifestations.
Sure. Absolutely. I really can't believe it myself sometimes when I think about it. So I heard about the Law of Attraction when The Secret came out in 2009. So I'm sure a lot of other listeners were introduced to it that way. So in 2010, I wanted to go on a cruise. I had never been on a cruise.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, okay, let me do some Law of Attraction. So I printed out a picture of the Norwegian Gem cruise ship. And I put it on my wall in my office where I work near my computer. And I visualized going on a cruise, and I just looked at that cruise ship all the time. So what happened is at the end of the year in 2010, my husband was downsized from his job. So I had put the cruise on hold. And luckily, he found another job in the beginning of 2010. And the cruise was back on. So I booked a cruise for the family. I have a husband and 2 children.
Mm-hmm.
And we sailed from Bayonne, New Jersey to Bermuda, not on the Norwegian Gem, but on a ship called the Celebrity Summit. So when we were in dock in Bermuda, the very last day, the whole time that we were in dock, we were right next to the Norwegian Gem.
Wow.
So I did see that exact same ship down in Bermuda, even though it wasn't our ship. And when we were leaving to go back to New Jersey, I took some pictures of the Norwegian Gem. And later on, I looked at the pictures, and the pictures were exactly the same picture of the Norwegian Gem that I had printed out on my computer the year before.
Wow. You know, Janet, that just gives me chills because, I mean, what are the chances of you taking the exact replica, the exact picture? And I believe that that picture was in your office, and every time you looked at it, the subconsciously it was getting down deep on the inside of you. How did you feel when you saw when you recognized or realized that it was the same picture?
Oh, I was so excited. It affirmed my manifesting ability, and just it affirmed the fact that the Law of Attraction really does happen if you work it.
Right. So I have a question for, were you saying, thank you, God, that we're going on this cruise? Or were you visualizing it? Tell me specifically, what were you doing besides just having the picture in your office? Were you thinking about it often, et cetera?
I was. I did a lot of visualization about it. I looked up the different things that we would be doing in Bermuda. Even before I booked it, I always was looking it up on the internet to check the price and the sailing dates, et cetera. So I visualized myself and my family just going on the cruise,
mm-hmm.
even when the circumstances weren't allowing it. And then eventually I was able to do it, and the circumstances changed.
Right.
My outer surroundings or my circumstances got to a point where I was able to do it, so I attracted that. And then I couldn't believe that I actually took the same picture. But I've heard of other people doing that because I listen to your show all the time. So
mm-hmm.
it was really kind of cool that it happened to me.
Right. And what I want to say to listeners is that you can't control how the manifestation will happen in your life. Your job is just to stay true and focus in only on what you desire. Wow, that's a remarkable story. So, Janet, you have some minutes, but I want to hear about the fundraiser. Tell me about that.
That's
so cool.
That's a fun one, too. Okay, so every year, the town that I live, we have a fundraiser called Ladies Night Out, and it is to benefit the public school system where my children go to school.
Mm-hmm.
And it is in a very nice catering place, and you buy a ticket, and you have a buffet dinner with drinks. It's an open bar.
Mm-hmm.
And then you also, in addition, buy tickets for raffle baskets. So in some parts of the country, they call it a tricky tray.
Mm-hmm.
And I always buy the tickets, and you are able to look beforehand on the website which baskets you want to bid for or put in a ticket for. So I always I like this chocolate basket. It was a beautiful basket of chocolates and cookies from a fancy chocolate store nearby that donated it. So I won a couple years in a row. And I guess it is because I visualized it. I really wanted to win. So I put a lot of tickets each year into it. But so I won 2 years in a row. But the third year, which was 2015, I actually put on my Facebook page a picture of me holding the chocolate basket from the year before.
Wow.
And I said, I am so excited to win this chocolate basket again tonight at the Ladies Night Out event. And so a lot of people liked it. And then when I went to the event, a lot of my friends there said, oh, Janet, I just know you're going to win it. You're going to win for sure. And sure enough, I won it again last year.
Wow.
But that was another, I guess, proof of my manifesting capability, because that one, I really visualized it. I thought about it a lot. So
wow.
It happened.
Well, you set your intention and then you began to visualize it and see it. You told everybody, I am going to win this basket. Of course, so that means you affirmed it. And then you had other people coming into agreement with you, speaking and declaring it over your life. And so all of you were in the same vibration, collective consciousness. And look what happened. And I just love your stories, Janet, because it can be something small, something simple, whatever your heart's desire. But when you begin to learn, I hate to use the word formula, but when you begin to learn how to align yourself in the small areas, then you can use it in large areas. And then lastly, I want you to share about how did you get a big raise? Let's talk about that.
Okay. So I am in sales at a very large telecommunications company.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in the, I guess, the first rung of sales. So it was small accounts, and it was just kind of like the low-level job. And I realized that I felt like I am ready to be in the next level and get a promotion. I just knew I was ready. So what happened was, it was about April or so, I started applying for different positions in the company. And it was slow going at first. I had one interview. I didn't hear anything back, and then no jobs were coming up. But then a job that was two levels above what I had then, came up. I interviewed for it, and I got that job. And I only had one interview, and it was it went very well, and they hired me. So it was two levels above. I got a $22,000 raise.
Wow.
And it is a much better job for me. And I never lost faith, even when it was slow going at first, that the universe would just allow me to rise to that level. I really tried hard not to get down on myself or doubtful that it was going to happen.
Well, you know, Janet,
so that's how I use the law of attraction.
Right. And so once again, whatever your dominant thoughts, belief, feelings, words, and actions are, and you just continually stay aligned with that vibration, it has to come to pass. I was going to ask you, how did you feel when it looked like nothing wasn't happening, but you said you just stayed in faith, just knowing you didn't know how, but a higher paying job, more fulfilling job, a job that aligned with your lifestyle would come into your life.
Correct. That's true. I just had faith because of also my other manifestations. I had a little bit of faith. I have one more quick story.
Okay, go ahead.
It was just attracting a green soccer ball. One day, I used to have to go to another county for and kind of drive a little bit for my job. So one day I went to Target, and on the way there, I said, oh, I just want to see a green soccer ball. Mm. So I ended up going to Target, and I passed by a green soccer ball in the store. And it only took a few hours to do that manifestation. So little things I kind of play with sometimes.
Wow. And I think that that's a great practice, Janet, because once you practice with little things, it gives you the faith and confidence, and you can look back and see, okay, this is what I did to attract the green ball. Now, if I want to attract something else, I can use that same formula and just begin to set my intention, align my thoughts, feelings, actions, and beliefs with it. And it's scientific and spiritual. The universe or God has to deliver it to you.
Yes.
Wow. That's true. So what would you like to say quickly to listeners all over the world about manifesting?
About manifesting, just keep at it and have faith, because if you get negative, it surely won't work. So just keep doing it, and eventually if you manifest the little things, then the big things happen as well. And also listen to Constance and all the other Law of Attraction Radio Network shows, because I listen to everyone, and I love it. It just helps me have a lot of faith and learn more every day.
Well, Janet, you have just blessed millions all over the world, and I just want to thank you for having the courage to come on and share your story, and God bless you. And as I say on my show, today is the best day of your life, Janet, and 2016 is the best year of your life. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you, Constance.
Well, here I am, and I am with a client of mine, and I wanted her to come on because she is Exhibit A of how you can take baby steps and transform your life. And she has literally transformed her life from the inside out. And I just want to show you how you can begin to do that also. So, Leslie, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network.
Thank you, Constance. I'm really excited to be here with you today.
Well, I just want you to share from your heart. Why did you initially contact me for coaching?
Well, Constance, I've been listening to you for about 5 years now, and I had been in a pretty stable environment where I lived my whole life. Then 2 years ago, we moved to a totally different location, and I had changed everything in my life. Where I used to be for 50 plus years, I'm now in a brand new community. And I was also questioning my career. I was in real estate. And I was listening to one of your podcasts, and you had a conversation with a client, Katie, in Japan.
Good old Katie.
And your conversation with her really hit home that I was stuck, and I needed someone outside my life to help me get unstuck and to help me find the direction I needed in a new town.
Yeah, you know, that's a major life change where you've lived somewhere your entire life, your friends, your business associates, you're familiar with where the grocery store is. And so I did not remember that you had lived there that long. And so you contacted me. Had you been trying to do it by yourself, or had you had a coach before?
No, you know, I was trying to do it on my own. I would listen to the podcasts. I would read self-development books. But I realized at one point, at that point, that one cannot always do it on their own. They need a guidance. I need a facilitator, someone who can see things that they cannot see because they're too close to the issue.
You know, that's nothing but the truth. And it's so interesting. One of my clients, I told her, I said, I have two coaches. She's like, what? I thought you had arrived. I'm like, baby, nobody does it by themselves, and nobody ever arrives. So just kind of share with our listeners some different areas where you use baby steps to change your life and different strategies that we use, et cetera.
Okay. Well, I do want to share when I reached out to you via email, you called me back within 2 hours. And that was like a pivotal moment for me, because to have someone reach out, I really felt that everything was going to be okay, and that I was going to be redirected in a positive situation, positive direction. So when we started we talked and you understood my mindset and how I work,
mm-hmm.
and that I would not succeed if I did a drastic change, that I needed very small steps along the way that I could feel comfortable with, especially being in an environment where I really didn't know anyone. So that I could easily see comfort, but a little challenges along the way. So the first one, which I changed, was eliminating soda from my life, which is, someone might say, well, what? But that was a big decision for me. I enjoyed my Coca-Cola. I didn't drink a lot of it, but I drank about a can a day. And it was the need to do something positive for my own health and help me in my weight release. So I started, and I thought, okay, if I could not drink a Coke for 30 days, that would be really great. So at the end of 30 days, I made it without drinking one. And then I thought, well, if I can do this 30 days, maybe I can do it 60 days. And so another 30 days went by and I did not have a Coke. I instead drank water or iced tea. Then after that, the snowball effect started. It was like, why would I want to undo what I've been doing? And so 90 days turned into, 6 months turned into a year. Now it's been about 14, 15 months. I haven't had a soda. And over that time period, I lost, I released 10 pounds through just being able to change that one habit. But I didn't see any change until like month 11. There was no weight change on the scale. And at one time I thought, well, I gave up my sparkling Coke for water, which is so bland, But when I saw that the scale had actually tipped lower, it was like, oh my gosh, this is working. And those baby steps really have added up to a major reward for me.
Yeah, let me just interject something here. And you said, and most people try to do large, gigantic steps. But what happens is there's no consistency there. So people say, oh, I'm not going to do that. But what I love about baby steps is that over time, they turn into quantum leaps and impacts other areas of your life, because the law of momentum and that snowball effect is happening, even though you may not see it or feel it initially.
And they are easy, so I don't get overwhelmed.
Yeah.
It's easier for me to stick with the program and to not fall backwards, because it's just one little step, in the right direction. And in our coaching, you had a great quote that I wrote down some months ago, and I've always kept it in front of me because it's really helped me keep the focus on the value of baby steps. And you told me, you said, Leslie, it's not about the speed, it's about the direction. Mm. And it really put everything into focus for me that, oh my gosh, I don't need an instantaneous result, because society, we're all thinking that's what we need.
Yeah.
But these baby steps along the way, I'm going in the right direction. Like, they compound, the results compound. And then one day, all of a sudden, you look at yourself and you go, wow, I have gone this much further in my life. And it was not painful. It was not scary at all.
And what's happening is, I'm going to remember that one myself, Leslie. I need to meditate more on that. It's not speed, it's the direction. You're going in the general direction of what you desire. You setting a general intention to go in that direction. And so that's what happened to you. And unbeknownst to you, other things start, transforming on the inside, because transformation takes time, but it's permanent. Like, you would never go back to that Coke. You may drink one Coke, but you wouldn't, that would never be a habit again in your life.
Right. And, you know, I don't even know if I could drink one Coke constantly. It burst the beautiful memory I have of that. But, yeah. You know, it also helped me not to make decisions from a position of fear. Mm-hmm. And, you know, that's very, things can happen in our lives that can really all of a sudden challenge your thought of what direction to take. And like, especially for business, and I work in a commission-based business, and the fear of loss of income can really challenge one's ability to stay even on a baby step. But working with you helped me understand that I was trying to take control of things that I really shouldn't have. And that I was not going to be falling off the edge of the earth, that, you know, I was creating a fear that wasn't even realistic. And that working with you and these baby steps along the way really helped me move forward in a more confident attitude and be able to make decisions better.
Because everything is connected. When you take a baby step in one area, it impacts everything else eventually. And that's what's happening to you. What other area did you use baby steps that really changed and transformed your life?
Well, you know, I am in real estate. And when we moved to this very small town, I moved from Sacramento, the capital of California, to a very small town on the coast, halfway between LA and San Francisco, of 6,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't sure what to do with my real estate business, and there was a fear factor going on in there. But in our conversations, again, you were able to see how I worked, and that I was more of a, you know, relationship one-to-one person versus a aggressive, assertive salesperson, and that I needed to work in an environment that utilized my strengths and made me feel comfortable in introducing myself and rebuilding that real estate company.
And so how did you begin to move in that? Because I knew that, you know, I could have said, okay, I want you to do 10 listings in 1 month, but I knew that that wouldn't work for you. I knew that you're a baby boomer, and that your niche or your unique gift was mothering, nurturing, assisting first-time home buyers. And I even had you to begin to go back to your old clients, let them know where you are now and say, you know, would love to, even though I'm in a different area, if you have any referrals for me, I would love to have those. How did that work for you?
So, you know, I needed that validation from past clients that yeah. I was good at my career and how much they valued my work and my assistance. And that helped me continue forward. And so when I would meet someone new, I felt more confident in saying, oh, you know, I'm in real estate. And we would generate a conversation. And then I would ask, would you like to be part of my newsletter? Because I write an original content monthly newsletter, very different from any other typical agent.
Mm-hmm.
And they would say, sure, yes, you know. And I would get feedback saying, this is an awesome newsletter. You know, I would love to introduce you to other people. And so people love to help each other. And it's something that we know, but we don't think about ourselves, that someone else would be willing to introduce me to other people to help me grow my business. And I needed that little nudge, a little baby step from you to say, it's okay to put it out there, Leslie, that, hey, I'm new to the area. I'm an awesome realtor. I just need someone to make some introductions for me.
Right. And once again, it's according to your personality, because when you try to do something outside of your current belief or outside of your current personality, you just won't stay consistent with it. But yeah. if you can every day do what feels comfortable for you, then your comfort zone expands and pretty soon you come out of that comfort zone. But I think that the baby steps and having consistency and being persistent is what turns in, as I said earlier, into big quantum leaps. So powerful.
You know, it's an amazing adventure and journey. I mean, one step, and then over time, that really truly snowballs and where it impacts multiple parts of my life. I mean, my career, my my own hobbies have changed and grown. My self-confidence in myself, my appreciation and my self-love. I mean, you've taken me down this journey of self-love that's just very opening and accepting.
Well, and then lastly, share a little bit about you use baby steps with your exercise. And see, with baby steps, we're not looking for perfection. That doesn't exist. You know, I tell people all you can do is the best you can do. Maybe today you operate in a spirit of excellence, and that simply means today this was the best that I could do. Maybe one day, I know in my own life, if I didn't walk 5 miles every day, I would judge myself. But maybe that day I was very tired and had a very busy week. And so instead of being compassionate and loving toward myself and saying, okay, Constance, you did a great job with this 1 mile or 2 mile, or just doing Pilates. And so with baby steps, we set intentions, but there's no judgmental or criticism attitude that's attached with it. So how did you use baby step with your exercise?
Well, I knew that walking would be the best thing for me because I enjoy where we live. I can walk along ocean trails, and I can take you with me through my iPod. And so it's a very, can be very spiritual, personal reflection, but also healthy. But I know I needed to start slow on my steps because if I set that Fitbit to 10,000 steps right off the bat, maybe the first 3 days I would make it and then I would crash and burn and I'd probably say, forget it. But an interesting perception, I guess, of baby steps. I don't think people really understand that as a baby's learning to walk, they fall and then they get up again. And because a baby's not going to sit there and just quit. I mean, they're going to learn, they're going to get up again and try another step. And so using the baby steps with exercise has really helped me. I set my pedometer or Fitbit low, 2000, because I need to see some success to motivate me.
Yeah.
But then every month I would increase it 500 steps. And so, you know, the next month it was 2,500, then three. And it was a very easy, gradual progression. I'm up to 6,000 right now.
Congratulations. So,
thank you. And I know there's some days that I may not quite hit it for whatever reason. Sometimes I have to drive a lot due to work. But there are other days I'll exceed that 6,000. And so it will average out. But again, the key on baby steps is I can always start over. If I fall off, it's not going to be the end of all my exercise program. I have another opportunity to start again, whether it's in the afternoon or the next day. But just like a baby, I can get up and start again.
Wow. You need to have your own show, Leslie. That was good. And so once again, she's moving in the general direction of what she desires. And over time, it will be more specific. It will be 10,000 steps a day. But right now, her intention is just 6,000. And if she keeps doing that on a consistent basis, what will happen is that will automatically, and she'll want to go past 6,000. It's kind of like going to the gym and lifting weights. If you've been lifting 3 pounds for 3 months, one day you're going to go in the gym and you're going to say, oh, this is too light. And you automatically go to 5 pounds. And then after 3 months doing that, one day you're going to say, this is too light. And then you'll go to 8 pounds. And so what happens is when you utilize baby steps, you once again, you come from a place of transformational permanent change. That's awesome. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, thank you so much, Constance.
You've really changed. So how did you feel about the accountability piece, which is every week email me and let me know what you're doing. And then if, you know, I sort of harass people a little bit, then if I didn't hear from you, I'm like, Leslie, what's up? So how did you feel about that piece?
Well, accountability can be hard because it will show you what's not being done.
Yeah.
But by being accountable to you did two things. First of all, it did show me the progress to myself, what was occurring, because I would go back through our notes. I would review what was going on and I would type it out to you. And then I would realize, wow, I am moving forward. Mm-hmm. I just, you know, from day to day, you don't necessarily see that, but maybe in a week or a month of chunks, you do see it. But also in my accountability to you, I didn't want to let you down because I knew you were investing time and energy and thought back to me. And so I felt there was an accountability back to you in honor of what you give me.
Wow.
So that's important too. It was never set up front, but there's an understanding of, I want to show you that you invested time and energy. I know you don't always work with every person who contacts you.
I don't.
So mm-hmm. I wanted to make sure that I took value of what you were going to give me.
Yeah. And I'm so happy for you, Les. I can hear your dogs playing in the background. Don't be concerned about that. I'm so happy for you and so proud of you that you just changed your life. I mean, your relationships, because I had you do a lot of boundary work and begin to say no to people.
Yes, I did to learn boundaries. That was part of the self-care, self-love that I needed to set boundaries for myself, with certain family members and, you know, because I was allowing too much to be taken, you know, away from me.
Yeah. And we know that you you teach people how to treat you. And so how do you feel about your life right now?
I am in an awesome place. I am only going further with great adventures. I will always be learning and, but there's so much ahead of me, and it's because you have helped me and you've been like my guardian angel in helping me get a strong footing where I am now. And that's, I was on an unstable foundation and you've helped me put some concrete in some pillars there to help me go forward.
Thank you. So what would you say to somebody who's listening, who's been thinking about counseling? Was the investment coaching, was the investment worth it to you?
Oh my gosh, yes. I would tell someone, don't hesitate. The longer you wait, the longer the delay of getting results. I mean, we owe it to ourselves to take care of ourselves first, then we can help others. But if someone's thinking of working with you, I would tell them, don't delay. Call her in the next minute.
Well, thank you so much, Leslie. But it's more important about you sharing your life about how you're changing it from a transformational perspective versus behavior modification, which is outside. And I'm so happy for you. And God bless you for having the courage to really come on the air and speak to millions of people. Now I can say that word to you, Leslie, all over the globe. And you never know the word that you shared, how it would shift and change somebody else's life. So thank you so much. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you so much, Constance. It's been a wonderful journey. and I really appreciate all you have given me.
My pleasure.
Thank you for listening to Think, Believe, and Manifest. Constance Arnold will be back next week with another great show just for you. For more information, please visit fulfillingyourpurpose.com.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They learn much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Choice to sit it out or dance. I hope you try. It's a real Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
When you don't go to Geico.com, car insurance can be hard. Like early 90s heavy metal hard.
I'm yelling and screaming and I'm loud. Roar!
Geico makes it easy. You can review and update your policy or report a claim on Geico.com or the Geico mobile app. Because shouldn't we all have a little less stress in our lives?
I'm not even upset about anything!
Danny, I just figured out that if I switch to Metro PCS, I get two Samsung Galaxy phones free.
Cool, Dad.
And I could be a super dad with two free Samsung Galaxy phones and call myself Double Galaxy Man.
Or you could give the second phone to your sidekick.
Yeah, I guess I could do that.
That's right. Two free Samsung Galaxy On 5 smartphones are all yours when you switch to Metro PCS. Metro PCS. Wireless. Figured out.
Coverage not available in some areas. Sales tax not included in phone price. Excludes numbers on the T-Mobile network. See store for details and terms and conditions.